Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Kingdom Hearts Dream Drop Distance Critical Mode. I was doing some farming, but I decided to put at least a video up today, so it's really late, so sorry if I don't talk much. I didn't really notice the time until just now. It's almost 10, so I'd rather try and get a video out now.
Yes.
So it might be a little bit rushed. Of course though, I don't really plan on like making it bad.
Come on.
And sorry if my quality's bad. I'm actually using the mic on the controller since the PS4. So that means editing can be bad as well for this. I really don't like that, but I can't do anything about it. My hands are tied there. Sorry, it's just how this is. So I can do what I can, but that's about it. I don't know much about editing videos at all, so that's even worse. But hey, it's something. I'm still new, so I might be able to look into it later if I decide I want to. But if I start to get more people and all that, I get a bit more well known, I'll likely start putting more effort into my videos, but for now it's probably not gonna change much.
Ooh, what's that? Hey, any chance you're Neku's partner?
Huh? I'm not really sure. All I know is that my name is Rhyme.
You mean, you've lost your memory?
Yep.
Oh, sorry.
It's no big deal. You know what they always say. Sometimes memories just need a little help getting out.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
Huh, a little help. I know. Maybe Neku can jog your memory. Come on, Ryan, let's go find him.
Right.
That was Ryan. Beat's sister. Yeah. Hey, we'll do the Coliseum. Actually, not now. Nah, I got the time. Let's enter the Coliseum to show it off. This is called Flick Rush, and I'm ready to try it out. Training Cup. This is probably a really unfair team. This is actually a really easy game mode to understand, so for anyone who's actually played I'm trying to remember the name of the game. There was a card game for Kingdom Hearts. If you know what I'm talking about, then oh yeah, it's Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories. It's pretty much working the same way. Ah, crud. Right. It's really not that hard to understand. That's just like the easiest thing in my opinion to do. Weird. Should have worked. That one. And obviously the star means you can't break it. It's sort of obvious. The higher the number, the harder it is to break. If you block with a higher number card, it evolves. The card that evolves depends on the person you're using. So if you're using the pig thing, you get an elixir which heals you and your entire party. So, I got a star rank. You took the gold prize. Beginner's Cup. Once you get more used to it and further into it, you'll actually realize this can get pretty fast paced. And sometimes you just get lucky right off the bat like that. This is a really balanced character, as you can tell. Sadly, that is something that I can never build. Damn, that is so quick. Oh, what's the other stuff? And win. I'm pretty sure since one died, I did not get a star rank, so I might go back and do that later. Oh man, I started getting sloppy at the end right there. I definitely got sloppy. Oh hey, nice. Oh, it's probably because of like my successful blocks and attacks. But now I'm gonna end it there. And you don't have to do them in order, you can actually just... Well, you have to do them in order at first, but after you beat it, you can go back and do whichever you want. I'm gonna go ahead and fight the boss, so that continues the story.
Hey, Neku! It's you!
Sora. What? You actually still trust me?
Of course I do!
But you know that I tricked you, right? That guy in the black coat? He said he could send me home. Me and my partner. But I had to bring you to him first. Sorry.
No big deal. When it really mattered, you stood up for me. And besides, we're friends, right?
Friends.
Oh, hey, Neku. This here is Rhyme. Is she your game partner?
No. Sorry. I'm teamed up with somebody else.
Huh? What? Rhyme! Neku!
Get wrecked. Now, a good question I want to know is, where is Neku?
Hey, wait!
He's not knocked out as easily as Sora. That is for sure. Heck, I'm pretty sure Neku's stronger than Sora. Because Neku is quite powerful. What the? Whoa, what the heck? I haven't seen this before. Whoa, he can actually break the glass? Yeah, but this is brand new to me, so sorry. It seems noobish. In my first playthrough, he didn't break the glass. I sort of expected that. And this is the first boss too, so... they have fixed my jaw.
Ha!
time to try and kill this thing. Here's an example of a chin attack. Yeah, sometimes they can be pretty devastating. And sometimes they won't do much. With sword of bites. Yeah. That makes more sense for a first boss.
Riku! Huh? Hold on, Sora. Huh?
Joshua.
Hello, Neku. How long the days without you have felt.
Rhyme! I'm glad you're okay. Neku, do you know this guy?
Yeah. Joshua. He's my friend.
Okay. Are you the one who took Rhyme away? And why do you know my name?
If you'd like to settle down for a sec, I'll field your questions one at a time. Let's start with Rhyme. I'm hanging on to her dreams for her. They're my portal.
Huh?
Let's just say her dreams are a gateway between worlds.
Oh.
Next question. How could I possibly know your name, right? This town has a little secret. It only appears when someone out there has need of shelter. I'll spare you the details, but right now it's made up of my dreams. So of course I know you. I dreamed you up. I know your best friend Riku, too.
Really? You know Riku?
Well, yeah. I'm kind of omniscient.
Then where is he?
He's right inside this projection. In another imagining of this world.
You mean another Traverse Town? Can I get there with your portal thing?
Sad to say, it won't work for you. My portal thing only opens for the one with Rhyme's dreams. In this projection, you're seeing another chain of events, in another world trapped by the Dream Eaters. As for how the world got split in two, I have a feeling you'll need to ask this guy.
Him again!
Huh?
Who's that?
Plot twist.
Beat.
Shiki.
Riku.
Skull noise. That's a huge reference to their game. As you guys can tell, I try not to talk during cutscenes. And I typically won't do this, but I'll just go ahead and drop for Riku's. I try not to do this, but oh well. There's not much time left, so I'd rather try and complete them both right now. I was trying to farm a little as Riku as well.
You're done.
It's why I started off as Sora. Whoops. And let's see if we can just clear this quickly.
Over there!
Hey! We should stick together! Perfect. You can't expect me to... Chicky. No way.
How did you get here?
Who are you?
By choice or chance, you cannot control what you are not aware of. This wakeless sleep will be your prison, to wander forever.
What do you mean?
Riku! Don't you listen to that punk! Shiki's gonna be fine. She told me what's up. Hoodie here set this whole thing up, yo. He promised to send Shiki back to our world, and you was the cost of travel. Yo, this is seriously one half-baked excuse for a mission. Bet you ain't even a Reaper.
All right. Who are you? Wait!
I'm really sorry, Riku.
It's all right. Beat. Watch her.
I got this, yo!
All right. And sadly, since we're Riku, we can't actually do the same trick as Sora. Riku doesn't team up with his allies like Sora does. Sort of a bummer, but he gets a different kind of team attack. So if you think you can just rely on that one simple trick, yeah, you're sort of out of luck. If it doesn't work. And yeah, they can literally do that. So it's a good thing I do have Dark Barrier. Alright, good. I probably shouldn't be trying to loot while in the fight.
Yeah.
Yeah, this fight seems a lot easier. Of course, though, you can never get cocky in this kind of fight. Or that just might be what gets you killed. As you can see, since I wasn't being reckless like I was with Sora, he died rather easily in first try. Like you should be doing, like I should be doing, but yeah, I don't know. Either way, he's dead.
Hey, what is this?
What are we seeing?
This is so messed up, man! She's right here in front of me, and I can't reach her!
If your hearts are connected, you'll reach her.
Rhyme.
Neku.
Sora.
Now they both have skull noise. And they're all gone.
In their world, something happened that brought their existence to an end. To keep them from fading altogether, I gathered up the very last remnants of their dreams and looked for a place to give them refuge. It was then this world appeared to answer my call, and Rhyme's dreams allowed us to reach it. Here, I thought they might have a chance, that the pieces of their dreams could make them whole again. Imagine my surprise when I realized dreams take bodily form in this world. It struck me, by linking their dream pieces back together, maybe I could make them exist again. Maybe I could give them another chance.
It can't be that simple.
Well, why can't it? By ourselves, we're no one. It's when other people look at us and see someone, that's the moment we each start to exist. All they needed was for someone to see them, connect with them. And the two of you were a big part of making it happen.
Joshua, just who are you?
Let's say, a friend.
One dream is connected to another, which means we must choose in which sleeping world you will begin. I will return you to the Destiny Islands just before they were swallowed by the darkness and plunged into sleep. Once dreams take you, you must let them guide you to the sleeping worlds. As there are 7 pure lights, there are 7 sleeping keyholes. Unlocking these will both grant you new powers and free the worlds from their weightlessness. Complete this task and return here safely, and I will name you both true masters.
Well, there you guys have it. Sora and Riku have both completed the first world, called Traverse Town. I didn't 100% it, but hey, what can you do? I might go back later and farm there. Until next time, guys, peace out and have a great time. Because this is the end.